Hey all. This New Stones, it's not new, but New Stones release of an old song. You know, the if you're a Stones fan or a Jimmy Page fan or a Zeppelin fan, you've heard rumor of this song for many years. And I always wondered what it sounded like because I had heard it described as a loose jam. You know, the finished product of Scarlet doesn't sound like a loose jam. That's a fully structured song. So that's a pleasant surprise. So I've heard it once, played it all the way through, listened to it, got a feel for it. I haven't tried to play it or anything. So what we're going to do is we're going to listen to it. I don't know what tuning it's in. That was, you know, the open G period, 73. So we'll see. But I've got it tuned to standard. So let's listen to it and see. We're going to learn it on the fly here and go through for what we hear and try to figure out what the tuning is. It's got minor chords in it, so my first instinct is it's in standard tuning. But let's see. Let's listen and just not try to play it. Just listen for a second and see what we hear. Now, this is where the debate starts. Some people are probably going to disagree with it. It's open G, is my guess. And here's what gives it away. Now, it's this little E lick. It sounds like... something like that, right? But one thing you can hear, and see if you can hear it. Listen for this note. That G. Because when he's doing... tell he's hitting the G, you can hear it. In between those little once or twice you hear that note. Listen. Hear it? Now that note is a G, so let's try this. That's what I think it is, because he's doing what you would do if you were just playing this little lick in E. You're not too worried about the A string. You're doing D, G, and B at, what is that, 9, and then suspending the B up. Then the second part of it is the G string at 12 back down there. To 9, but when he's doing the chucka-chucka part, that A string's tuned down to G, so he's accidentally, I don't know if it's accident, it sounds like an accident, but he's hitting it. It's not as obvious as I just did it, but listen again, you'll hear it. It's in there. So, open G, that's my best guess. So, let's try... it sounded like... now the advantage of this, I'm keeping the low E string at E. Instead of taking it off or tuning down to D or even tuning up to G. I leave it there because if the song's in E... that's the advantage of having it. If I have to do an E chord, and I'm pretty sure it does hit this at some point. You know, that stuff. You can have a full and get the low note in there, but we'll get to that. Let's just see what we hear and try to play along with this thing for a second. We'll be right back. so we got some of it, I think. It's in the verse is. Just that, really, just on those three strings. You know, I think he's accidentally hitting the open G string, but you would put. Suspend up on the B string. That one's. D stays where it is, G goes 12-9. So decide for yourself how much chucka-chucka you want in there. And then it's just. Sounds like a full E. And then you're into the Scarlet. A. All the way across. Forget the low E. Yeah, it's what's that? C sharp minor. Then B minor. So that's just these three strings, D, G, and B, at 6-6-5. So, A. Just move that down, 2 frets to B minor. You're gonna have the high E on that one. Doing a bunch of these now. So we're back to this again. On those chords, I'd do A. I'd do that high E in there with those. So just layer your C sharp minor shape, but then have the high E in the same fret there at 6. Then do it at 4. Back to this. So let's see if it goes anywhere. We're just turning. So when we're at a bunch of A, E to D. He does the C sharp minor. To D. That's E, and I think that's where we are now. Thank you. sounds like the whole thing. You gotta give Jimmy Page credit, because that's an understated Jimmy Page guitar solo. He could have gone nuts. You know, as when he was doing sessions, maybe not so much with Zeppelin, because there was a full-out assault usually. When, I mean, yes, there's subtleties to their studio work, but this was a very restrained guitar solo, which is what the song needed. I think one hit to the body, they probably said, do your Jimmy Page thing, you know, and he did. Fine solo, but not like this. This is really an elegantly done solo, just enough, you know. But it sounds like we got it. I'm going to go with open G. It's a little accidental G string in there. And then... And then A. C sharp minor. B minor. Then back to E. Then that goes to that part. The D to E part. Then the C sharp minor. Doing it like that, and don't get too much harmonic in it. You want chukka chukka, you don't want harmonic. So I'm gonna call that complete. Open G in the key of E, a little weird, but he did do that sometimes. A few minor chords in it, but they're not nothing. And you get the C minor, A. C sharp minor, B minor, E. Yeah, I like that one. The other one, Crisscross, that might grow on me. I gotta hear it a few more times. This one, I just like the funkiness of that little Keith riff that he's doing. And I assume Woody is on this. I mean, I know they recorded at the Wick in his recording studio in the basement, so I assume he's on it. And I don't know if it was it. I heard an interview with Mick, and they put it on the Goat's Head Soup thing. Well, all you, some real Stones fanatic will know. But I swear this was recorded in 74, and maybe it was for Ronnie Wood's solo album. I don't know. Because Goat's Head Soup was already out by, what was this, October? This would have been fall, October of 74. So I don't know what the deal of the timing of this was, because it's closer to... It's only rock and roll than Goat's Head Soup. So maybe I got the dates wrong, but I swear it was something that Ronnie Wood was very much a part of. And that it was for his album and not for Stone's album. Because I think Mick and Keith were on that Ronnie album. Was it I Got My Own Album to Do, or whatever that album was, Far East Man, that period? I don't know, something. Chime in with it. That's what the comment section's for, somebody who knows. Chime in with it, but I'm gonna call that done, and maybe we'll do it properly all the way through at some point. But I think that's how I play it. Good luck.